Happy morning, students. So the last class we studied about the female reproductive system. I hope you understand the concept. Now we move on to gametogenesis. So this gametogenesis, as we studied in the first video, where the reproductive cycle even taken place. So we can proceed with the brief manner. Now this is gametogenesis. The process of formation of male and the female gametes in testes and ovary respectively is called gametogenesis. It is of two types, one is spermatogenesis in male and oogenesis in female. So here, the process of formation of haploid gamete. What is a haploid gamete? That is the male and the female. The male haploid will be the sperm and the female haploid will be the, yes, ovum. So from the diploid germ cells, so which one will be the diploid germ cells here? The diploid germ cell for the male is testis, and diploid germ cells for the female, it will be the ovary. In the gonad, so gonad will be the testis and the ovaries. So this is called gametogenesis process. It taken place in the primary sex organ where the testis and ovary and produce the sperm and ovum. Here the male, which is the spermatogenesis process, begins at the puberty. In female, there is a process called oogenesis and starts at the embryonic stage. So these are of two types, one is spermatogenesis and oogenesis. Spermatogenesis, which is occur in male, oogenesis process, which occur in females. Now we proceed with the spermatogenesis. So genesis is the development. The process of formation of haploid male gamete sperm in seminiferous tubules of testes is called spermatogenesis. I repeat, the process of formation of haploid male gamete sperm in seminiferous tubules of testes is called spermatogenesis. The inner wall of the seminiferous tubule contains two types of germ cells, spermatogonia cells and Sertoli cells. So Sertoli cells, which is otherwise called as a nurse cells, which we studied in the previous class. Germ cells divide and develop into sperm. Sertoli cells nourishes the developing sperms. The spermatogenesis takes place in two stages as spermatidogenesis and spermiogenesis. Here I repeat the thing, spermatidogenesis and spermiogenesis. In the spermatogenesis process, there will be the two stages called spermatido, okay, spermatidogenesis and spermiogenesis. Now we see about the spermatidogenesis. So it is the process of formation of spermatid. It involves three substages. They are multiplication phase, growth phase and maturation phase. So now we study one each phases. Multiplication phase. The spermatogonia, that is spermatogonium, undergoes repeated mitotic division and forms large number of diploid spermatogonia cells. So when it is a diploid, there will be the 46 chromosome which is present inside it. When it is a haploid, there will be the half of the chromosomes. So when it is haploid, what happened? The 46 chromosome divided by 2, which is 23. Okay, so the 23 chromosomes are called haploid, 46 chromosomes are diploid. And next stage is the growth phase. The spermatogonial cells grow in size by increasing cytoplasm and matures to form. So this will be the flowchart of spermatogenesis process. Here you can see the cells, the diploid cells, which is divides into the haploid cells. Here you can study the mitotic division to the meiotic division. Here you can see study the process from the spermatogonium to the spermatozoa. So now we move on to the thing. So this is two end, this is a spermatogonium. Okay. So here what happened, this two end cells, which is undergoes the mitotic function process, like two end is divided into two cells, that is two end and two end. So after that what happened, this cells cleaves into two, this cells cleaves into two. So this from the spermatogonium, here we can produce a spermatogonia that will be a number like 4 in number. So from this there will be the mitotic divisions. So what happened, the cells mature, the cells growth. So during that time what happened, the spermatogonia, which is lead to the primary spermatocyte, that is 2 and diploid, is transformed into the haploid stage by the meiosis. First reduction division is applied. So from the primary spermatocyte, it leads to the secondary spermatocyte, and now the meiosis second part process will be applied here. So what happened? So this leads to the spermatids. So this spermatids, here you can see NN haploid sperms, which is non-motile. So what happened after the cell differentiation? So this process here. So from this spermatogonium to the secondary spermatocyte, the process is called spermatogenesis. Here, from the spermatids to the spermatozoa, so the process will be like spermiogenesis. So from the spermatids, there will be the non-motile sperms which transformed into a motile sperms, which is called spermatozoa. So in the mammalian reproduction, in the male pattern, the hormone involves in the spermatogenesis process are, is a very very important question, so you just make a note. Testosterone is the major androgen, a steroid hormone involved in the sperm development. So this will be the one hormone. And next, gonadotropin releasing hormone, GnRH, is released from the hypothalamus and travels through the anterior pituitary region. GnRH stimulates the release of follicle stimulating hormone and luteinizing hormone, in short FSH and LH. So this FSH increases sperm development and LH stimulates the Leydig cell of testis to produce this testosterone, which promotes the sperm production. Okay, so Leydig cell is otherwise called as the interstitial cell. So this will be the hormonal control of spermatogenesis. So FSH acts only on the Sertoli cells, whereas LH act primarily on the Leydig cell. Okay, so there is the two hormone, which is for FSH, follicular stimulating hormone and luteinizing hormone. The follicular stimulating hormone is responsible for the Sertoli cells and LH is for the Leydig cells. The secretion of FSH is inhibited mainly by inhibin, a protein hormone secreted by the Sertoli cells. Secretion of LH is inhibited mainly by the testosterone secreted by the Leydig cells. So what happened? Secretion of FSH is inhibited by the inhibin protein hormone, which is secreted by the Sertoli. Secretion of LH is inhibited mainly by testosterone secreted by the Leydig cells. So testosterone acting locally on Sertoli cells stimulates spermatogenesis. FSH, follicular stimulating hormone, stimulates inhibin released from the Sertoli cells. So these are the hormonal control of the spermatogenesis. So from the hypothalamus, there will be the secretion GnRH. And in the hypothalamus to the pituitary region, what happened? There will be the anterior, which secretes the follicular stimulating hormone and luteinizing hormone. So this follicular stimulating hormone leads to the Sertoli cells and luteinizing hormone leads to the Leydig cells. So this stimulates the spermatogenesis process, and this here is a testosterone, the androgen production. So this will be the reproductive, and other organ respond to the testosterones. Okay, so next, so these is all the hormone control. There will be the low testosterone stimulate the hypothalamus. What happened? GnRH. Okay, here the pituitary gland, what happened? So it gives the strike to the anterior lobe and the posterior lobe. From the anterior lobe, we have the gonadotrophic cells to produce the luteinizing hormone and FSH, follicular stimulating hormone. This stimulates the Leydig cell. This stimulates by the seminiferous tubule. So LH stimulate the Leydig cells to produce the testosterone and to stimulate the Leydig cells. Here FSH stimulates the seminiferous tubule, and the 90 days here will be the thing, like spermatogenesis process, 75 days to mature spermatogenesis. So next we study about the oogenesis. So oogenesis occurs in the female. Okay, what is oogenesis? It is the formation of ovum or egg starts in the ovaries of the fetus before birth. How it occurs? There are 5 stages of oogenesis process. First one, the germinal epithelial cells divides repeatedly until many diploid oogonia are formed. From the oogonia, it grows to the form primary oocyte that's surrounded by the layer of follicle cells. The oocyte undergoes the first meiotic division to become a secondary oocyte and a first polar body, which is the haploid. The follicular cells surrounding the primary follicle develop into the secondary follicles. The follicle layer of the secondary oocyte thickens and folds to form the graafian follicles. When the graafian follicles become mature, it will move towards the surface of the ovary wall and rupture to release the secondary oocyte end. The secondary oocyte that has completed the meiosis II, when it is fertilized by the sperm, the final product of meiosis II is the ovum and the second polar body. And this second polar body, we will which is very very minute, so we can it's like an error there. This will be like a ovum, so the final end product will be the ovum.
The process of formation of haploid ovum from the diploid oogonia cells in the ovary is oogenesis. It begins at the embryonic development. Oogonia, it is a gamete mother cells which has 2M. At birth, many millions in fetal ovary. Primary oocyte, which undergoes the prophase first of meiotic division, temporary arrest in this stage. And next is the primary follicle. Primary oocyte, granulozoa cells which is present inside it, may follicles degenerate from birth to puberty. So 60,000 to 80,000 in each ovary in the time of puberty period. So secondary follicles are the primary follicles surrounded by the more granulosa cells and theca. And next will be the tertiary follicles. Here the secondary follicles is fluid filled cavity, which is the thing called anthrum. So this anthrum is like I will explain in the diagram. Okay, so this anthrum is like a cavity filled, a fluid filled cavity called anthrum. The theca layer, which is sort of theca interna, which is very vascular, and theca externa, which is fibrous. Theca interna has 10 to 15 layers follicle cells, which act as a membrane granulosa. This primary oocyte 2N within the follicle size increases and first meiotic divisions will be applied over here. Unequal large haploid secondary oocyte, the first polar body will be the producer. Here the secondary oocyte retain nutrient rich cytoplasm of primary oocyte, tertiary follicles into the graafian follicles, secondary oocyte, that is the ovum, to zona pellucida membrane, graafian follicle ruptures and release the ovum. So this will be the female reproductive thing. This will be the ovary which we studied in the previous class. So here you can see the primary follicle, growing primary follicle, primary oocyte, secondary oocyte. So you can see the anthrum. Okay, this will be the graafian follicle. What happened? So there is a space, a filled cavity called anthrum, and this is a time for like at the time of the ovulation. So what happened from the stage to this stage, maturing stage, it released the ovum. So this process is called ovulation. Okay, ma'am. So this is the ovum. So this will be the end product, which is a outer membrane. Here you can see the corona radiata, zona pellucida, and secondary oocyte. So here in the zona pellucida, the sperm will come and hit the egg regions. So this will be the diagram of an ovary showing the various stage of the ovum and the follicular development. Okay, so this will be the stages which is acquired from the primary follicle to the mature ovum. So this will be the briefly given diagram. So this is the primary oocyte, and next is the primordial follicles. So here you can see the layer called pre-granulosa cells, primary oocyte, and basement membrane. And next this lead to the primary follicle, which have the granulosa cells, zona pellucida has appeared in this region, primary oocyte and basement membrane. And next this lead to the secondary follicle. Here you can see the granulosa cell, zona pellucida. Here you can see the theca cell. Theca is the outer derm layer of the follicles. And next it leads to the tertiary follicle. Here you can see the full setup like theca externa, theca interna, basement membrane, granulosa cell, anthrum, and zona pellucida. So here the space filled cavity called anthrum. Okay, so when the first meiotic division completed, what happens? So this will be the graafian follicle. What happened? So here you can see the complete structure, like in the second meiotic division process, the fertilization completion of a second meiotic division process, you can see the outer membrane, inner membrane, granulosa cells, and these cells are arranged in the thing. And here you can see the anthrum, which has the spacious cavity. Okay, so this is a fluid cavity. And next there will be the ovulation process, like ovulated ovum. So this will be the ovum structure. So it's like a secondary polar body, fertilized oocytes, and corona radiata, which is outside the region. So this will be the microscopic view of ovaries. Okay, so this will be the ovum. So you can see this. So this will be the ovum. Okay, so this will be like a graafian follicle, anthrum, corona radiata, zona pellucida, oocyte, which is seen in the ovum. So zona granulosa, this will be the outer filled cavity of the graafian follicles. So oogenesis take place by three stages, as like we studied in the spermatogenesis. There will be the three phases, multiplicative, growth phase, and maturation phase. So what happened in this multiplication phase, what happened? There will be a certain primary germ cells, which is larger in size of germinal epithelium lining ovary, undergo rapid mitotic divisions. So multiplicative or multiplication, you can say anything, okay. So it results in the formation of group of diploid egg mother cells called oogonia. So each group of cells form a round mass cell called egg nest. And next in the growth phase, what happened? There will be a long duration, like 12 to 13 years. So one of the diploid oogonia undergoes the growth increasing in cytoplasm and accumulation of yolk and transform to enlarged oogonia called primary oocyte 2A. Other oogonia from single layer follicle epithelium is the primary follicle. The primary follicle surrounded by the more granulosa cells leaks to the secondary follicle. From the secondary follicle, there will be the fluid-filled antral cavity, that is antrum, to the tertiary follicle. Now the tertiary follicle leads to the graafian follicles. This is a maturation phase. A fully grown primary oocyte 2N undergoes first meiotic division, results in the formation of two unequal sized haploid cells. The large secondary oocyte and small podocyte, which is a polar body, the secondary oocyte undergoes second meiotic divisions to form a large ootid. So ootid is otherwise called as ovum, is otherwise called as egg, is otherwise called as ova, and two second polar bodies. Secondary oocyte forms new membrane called zona pellucida, which is leads to the graafian follicles. The first polar body also undergoes equal division to produce the two cells. Thus, during the oogenesis process, four cells are produced. Among them, one is functional ootid and three are non-functional polar bodies. The ootid with very little change becomes an ovum. So this will be the complete flowchart of the oogenesis. Here you can see the oogonium. This is a mother cells, okay, mother cells of the female gonads. So what happened, this is a oogonium. So here you can see the 2N have deployed and it leads to the 2, which undergoes the mitotic division. So this process from the oogonium to the oogonia, and next what happened here, you can produce there will be the 2N, 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 and after that what happened, the cells undergrow growth and it leads to the primary oocyte. Here from this, the meiosis first reduction part will be taken place. What happened from this reduction, there will be the N in, and here you can see there will be the. So this is the flowchart of oogenesis process. So it starts with the oogonium, which leads to the oogonia. Here what happened, there will be the mitotic divisions, mitosis process taken place here, 2N to 2N, and this 2N give rise to 2 cells, and this 2N give rise to 2 cells. What happened next, the cell growth to the oogonia, to the primary oocyte. So what happened, there will be the 2N. If from the primary oocyte, the cell undergoes a meiotic division. So first meiosis process taken place here, so there will be the reduction division. So what happened, there will be a big N and small N. So this is a secondary oocyte and first polar body. Here you can see the secondary oocyte and first polar body. And from the meiosis 2, what happened in this, here you can see the two the thing from this, the haploid cell, you can see the two haploid cells, one that is bigger in size and which is other three are the smaller in size. One bigger size, the end product will be the ovum, and these are the second polar bodies which is present in the thing. So this will be the process of oogenesis. Thank you. I hope you understand the concept of gametogenesis process. So you just revise according to the topic. Thank you.